about today. This is a chilly March 29th, 2022. We're at the busy Long Island Railroad Ronkonkoma station, the end of the electrified zone on the main line. Going to take a ride to Greenport today on train 250. If my calculations are correct, it will have DM30AC409 with a K5 LLA horn. But whether it has that engine or not, we'll take a ride on this picturesque line out to Greenport, the end of the main line that was reached in 1844. Beautiful day today, but cold. Well, here comes the equipment for train 250, coming out of Mid-Suffolk Yard, pulling into track one here at Ronkonkoma Station.
Space here in Ronkonkoma, but somehow I knew it would be a little easier today, but not that much easier. I had to park on the Iceland Town lot as opposed to the Brookhaven lot on this side. But I did. The difficulty kind of convinces me that ridership is back. Right around here is where the old Ronkonkoma diesel yard used to be in Y track, where they used to store the Greenport scoot in the off hours when it wasn't running. Usually an engine and a 2900 series P72. Yeah, conductor collected my ticket. A lot of residential growth here. This is old woods when I was a kid.
This is the train to Greenport. The next station is Medford.
You hear Medford, the next stop. Years ago, back in the 60s, you had Holbrook and Holtsville station before Medford. There's a soundproof wall here. So the soundproof wall is to protect residents. On the opposite side is Mid-Suffolk Yard, a very large MU yard here on the island, recently expanded. Try to minimize the noise from the yard with this soundproof walling. It's like the Great Wall of China almost. It's like it goes on and on and on. This is skirting the yard here. This is Knickerbocker Avenue. We're just east of the yard complex and the KO Interlocking Complex. This is a scenic ride. Between here and Riverhead, you go through the Pine Barrens, lots of woods that stretch for miles, seemingly. And east of Riverhead, it's farmland. You see a very rural side of the island out there. Here's the approach signal to KO we just passed. Steakhouse. Love their meat, love their bread. Distance signal to KO. is Long Island Avenue. That parallels the main line quite a distance. Speed limit on this stretch of track is 45. I think east of Yaphank or Riverhead it's 40. But don't quote me. Ocean Avenue runs up towards Mount Sinai. Out to the Hamptons and Montauk, the line of Greenport doesn't have quite the same flair as that line does. It doesn't have the business, it doesn't have the amount of trains. The track hasn't been renovated or resignaled. It's kind of a sort of neglected part of the East End, but people who live out there prefer it that way. It's not quite so crazy in the summertime going out here.
Station is Medford.
Coming into Medford. The highway we're going over here is New York Route 112. Runs between Patchogue and Port Jefferson. Two very important Long Island Railroad diesel terminals. A lot of freight business, a lot of freight customers on this line, going all the way out to Parico Gas and Riverhead. New York and Atlantic serves a lot of these places. In fact, we might see one of those freight trains today. I think RS-70 went out ahead of us from Ronkonkoma, and we might pass him at Yaphank.
The next station is Yaphank.
RS-70 usually goes out to Parico Gas on Mondays. Well, today's Tuesday, so we might just go as far as Brookhaven Terminal, which is west of Yaphank.
train to Greenport. The next station is Yaphank.
A lot of county offices are out in Yaphank. Suffolk County Sheriff's Department has their office there. Sunny day, but it's been incredibly cold the last couple of days. This time of year, yesterday, it was only in the 30s. That's crazy. But I plan on going to Philadelphia on Thursday. On that day down there, it's going to be in the 70s. Still with us. I think that overpass was Horse Block Road. K5 LLA horn working. Sounds like he's blowing it pretty good. Sills Road. Scenery here as we approach Yaphank. I believe they run a rush hour train from Ronkonkoma to Yaphank and a couple of Greenport round trips. I think they run run a riverhead train for court workers. Years ago, back in the 70s, they used to run a rush hour train from Hunters Point Avenue to Yaphank. Used to have 17 cars. I think New York and Atlantic RS-70 is sitting in the siding here at YA. You can see a cut of cars. Who does a lot of talking. In fact, that reminds me. When I was in the Air Force, we had a guy in my basic training outfit. His name was Hank. His last name was, are you ready for this? Mikola von Furstenrecht. Henry Mikola von Furstenrecht. 21 letters in his last name, and he had two name tags on his uniform. That's a Hank I'll never forget. Here it is. Here's the cut of cars from the freight, RS-70.
This is the train to...
out of lumber.
Greenport. The next station is... Riverhead.
Don't see any engine unless he's parked somewhere. Here it is. Those might have been the lumber cars I saw sitting at Pine Air on Friday when I was riding on the Ronkonkoma train with the Flying Yankee. Now we're getting into the rustic country here. Soon you'll see a track going off to the left here. That's the old Upton Junction siding. Went up to an old army base, Camp Upton. It's where Brookhaven National Laboratory is now. Locomotives that have the K5 LLA horn. The others are 413 and 423 of the DEs, 504, 521, and 509 of the DMs. Did you know that little signal there? That's a switch indicator for YA, for westbound trains. That's the William Floyd Parkway we just passed under. track to Upton jump, the Camp Upton. What, did I miss it? Boy, they've been doing a lot of tree cutting around here. Look at that. Spoiling Long Island's pine barrens. Well, we're not really into the heart of it just yet. Junction, right up to the old army base, Camp Upton. That was a base where people processed out to go overseas during the World Wars. Look at this. All these solar panels. Ago, this line ran a couple of summer trains. Most noteworthy, on Friday nights they ran a train called the Shelter Island Express. Ran out to Greenport after Jamaica's first stop was Riverhead. That was Wading River Road there. Wading River is noteworthy. That used to be the terminal for the Long Island Railroad until the late 1930s. Then they brought the railroad back to Port Jeff. A lot of people out in places like Rocky Point, Shoreham, and Wading River wish that they extended the railroad back there again. This Route 25A is loaded with traffic. through Manorville here. There's a trackside restaurant that I ate at a couple of months ago. It is here that the old Eastport branch used to diverge off to the right. That was abandoned back in the 40s. Right here is MR, Black Limit Station. To Greenport. He's doing at 2:10. Scheduled to leave Ronkonkoma at 12:46. Should see another track going off to the left here. That's the Calverton Spur. It goes up to the old Grumman Aeros, what used to be the Grumman Airport there. Serves a lumber company. New York and Atlantic switches that once in a great while. To go to. Lots of endless pine barrens. Switching on that branch. There's a road that parallels the spur. You can get a couple of shots, and there's a railroad crossing with gates and lights that doesn't go down very often. Like I said, that spur isn't served very frequently. Need the luck of the Irish to catch it. Well, I'm Irish, and I was lucky that day. But no small credit goes to rail fans who tipped me off. Thank you. of the Peconic River Preserve. That signal back there was the switch indicator for MR. See a siding out there. They don't, doesn't look like they use it anymore. This is the black limit station of A.H. Calverton. Crossing was Edwards Avenue. Right here on the opposite side, the old shed for the old Calverton station is still standing. It's been gone for decades. Expressway. Approaching Riverhead. Riverhead is the county seat of Suffolk County. Rather large community, a lot of courts are there. Whenever I'm on jury duty, I always have to go to one of those courts. It's about a 45-mile drive from my house. Years ago, back in the 80s when I was working, got assigned to a grand jury. I had to go out there every day for a month. Loved it. In fact, back in 2007, I served on a criminal court in the county court building. I had to do that for about 2.5 weeks. Loved that too. Interesting experience, and I got full pay for my job. I'm glad gas was cheaper back then because I had to drive 90 miles a day. It's Queens Boulevard in Queens. Runs all the way out to Orient Point. Okay, right here is Parico Gas. It's served by the New York and Atlantic once a week, usually on Mondays. Got three tank cars in there. Sometimes they serve it more than once, but when the warm weather comes, they don't serve it that frequently. And a lot just north of there, there were a couple of, I think they were Missouri Pacific Cabooses. Jerry, who's a proprietor of the Long Island Railroad Museum, which you will see up here in Riverhead. moved them on trucks to the museum grounds. You'll see their collection up here. Station LD, Riverhead. P-72s from the railroad, built in the 50s, baggage car. Is it a Osgood Bradley car? There are the cabooses I was telling you about. Did a good job moving them here. This is one of those old double-decker trailers that the railroad had. Another baggage mail car. Here's another 2900 series P-72 car. They were among my favorites to ride on when I was a kid. This is a Bud-built M1 car. Cars, because they came in a set of two. And one thing about this line many years ago, this area was a great producer of potatoes. Long Island Railroad used to run huge trains of potatoes out of here. Like 70, 80 car trains of potatoes. Not anymore. New York and Atlantic goes out as far as Parago Gas, but they will sometimes park the train on the siding here at LD and they'll run around the train and then go back and switch the plan. Now look at these Bud M1 cars. The museum over there. Look at that BEDT switcher. There's a caboose turntable, little toy train track. Route 25, New York Route 25. It'll pretty much play hobnob with us all the way to Greenport. From here eastward, the topography changes. Instead of deep woodlands, we come out into open farm country. Beautiful country out here. Lots of wine vineyards. As much as I like to drink wine, I've never gone to one of those vineyards. It's on my to-do list, my bucket list, my wine bucket list. Want to buy a cheap house? Buy it here, it's trailer camp. right there. That's where the old Aquabog station used to be. It was just a puny station. Supposedly had a short platform with two light poles on it. The remnants of the Jamesport station platform. I'll try to get it. It's still there. It was discontinued in the, I think, 84. Platform, you can see a little chunk of it. All these towns between Riverhead and Greenport on Route 25, which is not far away from the railroad, very pleasant towns. Grape vineyards, restaurants. Prettiest towns on the East End. It doesn't have all the crass commercialism that the Hamptons have, or the disorganized chaos. It's more like the country rather than the sixth borough of New York City. Although I'm not knocking the South Fork and the Hamptons, during the off season it's very peaceful out there, but in the summertime it's wall-to-wall people. You don't quite have that crowded throng up on the North Fork. Here's a vineyard. These towns don't have the craziness of the South Fork, you know, the Hamptons, but people to a man will tell you that's the way we like it. This area of Long Island is like Stan Laurel from Laurel and Hardy. I'll show you where the old station used to be. That was discontinued, I think, in the 80s. Right there, I think, is where the old Laurel station used to be. Horses. All right, here's Route 25 ducking under us here. Thank you.
station is Southold.
Up until the late 1960s, the next stop would have been Cutchogue after here. All the passenger trains, revenue passenger trains through here, all run out of Ronkonkoma. But there's one exception. In the summer months, on Friday nights, they run a train 255 from Greenport right through to Jamaica, revenue train. Love Lane. A lot of these towns until, I think, the 80s, served by road and rail buses. They were Long Island Railroad painted buses.
This is the train to Greenport. The next station is Southold.
The name Sound Avenue. here, we just went over Depot Lane crossing. This is where the old Cutchog station used to be. That was discontinued in the 60s, but don't quote me. All I know is we don't stop there anymore. Cutchog, C-U-T-C-H-O-G-U-E. It's like Patchog, but it's Cutch instead of Patch. People sometimes mispronounce it and call it Cutchagoo. Or Cutchogee. Through the village of Peconic. These vineyards are in the early stages now, but come like August and September, there's going to be quite an aroma here. Intoxicating. That's where the old Peconic station used to be until the late 90s. It was talk years ago of breaking up the eastern Twin Forks of Long Island into a separate county. They were going to call it Peconic County, but never materialized. Horton's Lane.
This station is Stockholm.
Southhold is the seat of the town of Southhold. Station here is SD, Sam Delta. Further than Philadelphia is from Penn Station.
This is the train to Greenport. The next station is Greenport.
See a scenic highlight of the line between here and Greenport. We'll be passing over Hashimomunk Pond. Very photographic location. I know some guy from Nassau County who loves to take pictures there. Switch indicator westward for SD black limit. Who work these Greenport scoots have seniority. It's a nice laid back, relaxed kind of run. It's like running a branch line from the rest of the helter-skelter of the railroad. Here's Hashimomunk Pond right here. Beautiful shot, beautiful view here. Thank you. Bixedon, B-E-I-X-E-D-O-N. Greenport has quite a history. Jumping off point many years ago for ferry boats to Stonington, Connecticut. We can get on the train to Boston. Just passed under Route 25 again. I just love those horns. Crossings approaching Greenport. Signaled, but they do follow PTC rules on this. The PTC allows for less train separation. See the GY black limit signal over here somewhere. Right there. Greenport is a lovely town. I'll try to show some of it. We have a layover here of about 25 minutes. I'll try to show you some of the town, some of the railroad artifacts. It's a beautiful town.
This station is Greenport.
6th Street. Here too, here's some of their equipment. Caboose, Pennsylvania Railroad boxcar, and a snowplow. This is it, Greenport, the end of the line. It's a great ride. We're going to be, well, it's 2:14, we're 4 minutes late. But an excellent ride.
And there's our steed that took us out here. D30AC409. You've heard that K5 LLA horn blowing. Here on the south side of the tracks west of the station, you see the remnant of the old turntable. I've seen many a diesel turned on this turntable. Well, here's Greenport Harbor. That piece of land you see over there is Shelter Island. The only way you can get there is by ferry boat on both the north side and the south side. Shelter Island is its own township. Very upscale township. A lot of influence comes out of Shelter Island. The station building at Greenport was built back in 1892. Now it's some sort of a museum. There's the absolute east end of the Long Island Railroad's main line. The tracks many years ago used to go right out onto the docks there, but the docks were much wider. Very picturesque town, but it's cold. It's 37 degrees here right now. Hard to believe day after tomorrow I'll be wearing summer clothes in Philadelphia. And you're looking at the Shelter Island Ferry. The dock is right next to the station. Getting ready to shove off for the north side of Shelter Island. This is the north ferry of the Shelter Island Ferry. It's much longer than the south ferry. It's just a short crossing there. There was talk about building bridges off of Shelter Island, but the residents there, like I said, they're highly influential. They said, no, absolutely not. They want to preserve the quaintness of the place. Here he goes. What the train station is today, the East End Seaport Maritime Museum. This is the ferry terminal here. They run pretty frequently. There's currently 3 ferry boats operating. Here comes another ferry arriving with a FedEx truck on board. You can see the prices to ride on the ferry. Oddly enough, the South Ferry is a much shorter ride and it costs as much. Get more bang for the buck riding on the North Ferry than the South Ferry. Watch your back. Minutes roughly. Believe it or not, this ferry is part of a highway. State Route 114 runs from East Hampton to Greenport. It involves traveling on 2 ferries to get between those points. Alright, you turn right on Route 25, it'll take you to the Orient Point Ferry. 9 miles. That's where you catch the ferry to New London, Connecticut. New York is 80 miles. Remember I said it was 94 miles from Long Island City, well, the 80 miles designates the distance to the New York City limits, you know, Queens. Well, here's the village of Greenport. Beautiful town, lots of shops, restaurants. Bustling in the summer, but not quite like the Hamptons. Well, it's a brief tour of Greenport. I don't want to miss this train out of 2:43, because if I do, I'm stuck here till 9:49 tonight. No thank you. And we're heading back west. Get some highlights of the trip back. You can see the turntable there. Note the Twin Forks chapter, who owns it. This is train 251. Vineyards. A lot of these farms used to be potato farms. Chalk station used to be. Signal we just passed. That's the Broken Down Valise Saloon. A golf course around Laurel, west of Manitouk. Thank you.
This is rural, less hectic Long Island. Suffolk. You get to see the 1910 built depot building. It was closed as a ticket office in 1972. You can see one of the courthouses in the background. Avenue crossing where the courthouse is located. I've had to go to that courthouse a couple of times for jury duty selection, but I wasn't picked. Here we are. Okay, here's the depot building coming up. Designed similarly to Bayshore and Northport, Mineola. We're a little ways out of Riverhead. We're going to be passing by Peconic Lake, one of the scenic spots on the line. Some of the scenic spots on this side when I wasn't able to catch on the other side. And it's pretty. I'll show you the remnant of the old Calverton station. You can see the old waiting shed. It's still standing here. See it? The station was closed decades ago. Yeah, we're approaching Manorville. Manorville has MR block limit station. It's where the Eastport Manorville branch joined up. That line was abandoned in the late 40s. You should see the MR block limit signal here. Out in the woods, the Eastport Manorville branch creeps towards us, or used to creep towards us. There, you see it? That was the MR block limit signal. Okay, we're approaching Lane Road. This is where the old Manorville station used to be. The Eastport branch came right up here. There's the Maples Bar and Restaurant. I have a feeling there was a lot of celebrating going on in there on election night 2016. Yeah, lots of freight business out here. I'm not sure what all these places are, but there's an asphalt factory out here somewhere, and the Long Island Railroad used to run gigantic trains of stone out to this plant. I think this is it right here. Lots of hoppers. Lawrence Avenue. This is where the abandoned Holbrook station used to be. Okay, we're coming into Ronkonkoma now. End of the run. Great trip out here to Greenport. Beautiful day, but cold. I'll show you the mid-Suffolk yard, the expanse of it. Last time I was here several weeks ago, there were six sets of M3 cars in there. Here's the yard. See the M3s back there? There's like one, two, three, four train sets. You get a good look at them here. This is the largest MU yard in Suffolk County. Superseded Babylon. They expanded the yard for the east side access. Look at all those M3s over there. I'm hoping they'll be back later on this year. They look like they're in decent shape. They don't look like they're ready for the scrap heap.
Run is complete from Greenport. Great ride.